You've been added to CIEE, Spring 2017 Seville Business and Culture. That's where it all started. My lifelong dream of studying abroad, seeing the world, meeting new friends, learning a language, everything I'd seen and idolized since I saw the Lizzie McGuire movie when I was 7 years old, without the creepy Italian guy. Immersing myself in a new life, full of fabulous people and fabulous things and just a whole lot of fabulousness. What I wasn't expecting, however, was to have my entire life outlook on other cultures shifted. And not in the cheesy, I'm saying this for my intercultural communication class kind of way, even though technically I am, but in the real, life-changing way. After spending almost 5 months here in Seville, traveling throughout Europe and Africa, Morocco counts, I couldn't wait for my parents to come visit. I'd been anticipating it for a while, and I couldn't wait to show them my city and furthermore my continent. My new home! One day, before sightseeing, we stopped for coffee. After waiting in line for a few minutes, two women moved in front of me, just walking on up, ordering without waiting. My dad was obviously pissed, saying, "What the hell? They just cut us. I need some coffee." Just to clarify, my dad is super easygoing. He just really needed some coffee. You know, we're all like that in the morning. Danielle. The situation as a whole didn't really impact me. I wasn't bothered by the women moving in front of us and told my dad, "Really, it's fine. I'll just wait and order after them. It's not a big deal." He looked at me, appalled, really couldn't understand my willingness to just let it happen. That right there is when I first realized my mindset had totally shifted. Throughout their week here, I kept having little epiphanies like that one. My parents would be frustrated when the waiter in Rome wasn't refilling our drinks every 5 minutes, or confused when I explained how there is literally never, ever, ever toilet paper in Spanish public bathrooms, especially here at the UPO. They were absolutely mind-boggled at the fact that Spanish people choose to embrace the "everything's broken but it's fine" attitude, or the acceptance that comes with a lack of central heating or air conditioning in my homestay, or really any building in Spain whatsoever. All these tiny little things that I never even think about twice anymore. One night, thinking about it, I realized that my mindset has changed over the past few months. And because my parents haven't necessarily explored outside their own cultural bubble, not to their own fault, but just because they haven't really left the States in a while, or if out with an intercultural, open-minded lens, they may not understand the way of life here the way I do. In fact, most of my friends at home won't understand it either, or my teachers, or my classmates, or countless other people who I'm going to be going home to in just a week and a half, which is really weird. My outlook on life has gone from the American customer is always right attitude that most of us tended to have upon entering this program to a more open, take it as it comes approach, rolling with the punches. I stopped reverting to my default American cultural lens and have begun to grow more conscious and curious, not only about my own personal behavior, but also about my interactions and actions and the impact they have on others. I find myself applying this openness everywhere I go, whether I'm in Spain, Germany, Morocco, Austria, or anywhere else. I inherently know that I have to adapt to wherever I may be and whoever I may be with. And to me, that's my biggest abroad takeaway, learning to live as a part of a new culture rather than observe it.